On the other hand, a great many Afghan civilians are killed by IEDs or suicide bombings targeting American forces when they're among the population. According to the UN, suicide and IED attacks kill more civilians than any other tactic used by parties to the conflict.
The most dangerous thing right now is the Taliban put in roadside bombs or improvised explosive devices along with the victim-operated pressure plates, which victims step on it and they go off. Pretty much that is our main concern now, since the Taliban is either gone, but we believe that they're hiding and observing us. And whenever we're not out, they're out putting their IEDs all over the place.
Now, both U.S. and Afghan commanders say Taliban fighters have left behind lots of booby-trapped bombs. Soldiers going through villages, they're finding what's known as IEDs, improvised explosive devices. They're everywhere, the side of the road, they're in fields, they are even hanging from trees or embedded in walls. Now, this is a strategy the Taliban has used before, but commanders say they are finding more of these booby traps than they ever expected. IEDs can be anything really, even something as innocuous as an old alarm clock like that, or a box, an old storage box like that.
There's too many of you crying. Brother, brother, brother.
Something like this isn't an everyday occurrence in the United States. Yet here in Afghanistan, it is. And the insurgents have used them on coalition forces and children alike. That's why airborne soldiers from Task Force Rock in Wardak province have teamed up with the Afghan security forces to educate children. Some, even as young as 3 or 4 years old, on the dangers of improvised explosive devices.
I've been told that the road in and out of Pakabishana had been checked recently and there were no known IEDs on the road. But that afternoon, we left the village and probably got about 50 yards outside the village on a dirt road. We're just passing by what looks like an abandoned motorcycle when a bomb exploded underneath the vehicle I was in. There were 7 people in the vehicle, including myself. Of those 7, 5 were hurt enough to need to be evacuated by helicopter. Myself and a medic were sitting in the very back of the vehicle, farthest from the blast, and we're mostly unhurt.